Hey guys, Matt here from MK-SmartHouse.com, and in this video, I'm going to give you a demo of the sprinkler system we will be creating. So what is this sprinkler system exactly? Well, it is a device that connects to our OpenHAB server through MQTT and listens for commands to determine which sprinkler valve to turn on. If I pull out a mobile device and open up the OpenHAB app, you can see that I now have five things in the outside frame. The first three things are switches that say zone 1, zone 2, and zone 3. And what these switches do is turn on the sprinkler valves that are connected to the device. The next item is 20 minute cycle. And this one goes through and activates each zone individually for 20 minutes and then goes to the next zone. I will demonstrate later. The next item is sprinkler system schedule. And it controls whether or not the OpenHAB system should do its pre-programmed scheduled watering of the sprinkler system. So if I turn it off, then it will not water by the schedule, which is every day at 5 a.m. But if I turn it on, then it will water every day at 5 a.m. One cool thing that I implemented in the rules, and will show you in the software video, is that whenever the system does its daily watering, then it will send you a notification before it starts watering to let you know what is going on. Now let's get into the demonstration of the device. I would just like to note that this device can control up to three zones, but currently at my house I only have two. So you will only see two sets of sprinklers activate on the lawn. Let's start off by controlling each individual zone. First I'm going to turn on zone 1, and as you can see the sprinklers in the zone came up and started watering the grass. Next I'm going to turn off zone 1. And turn on zone 2. And just like zone 1, you can see the sprinklers came up. If I did have my third zone up and running, I could turn off zone 2 and turn on zone 3. But currently, I do not have the hoses connected to those sprinklers. The next thing I want to show you is the 20 minute cycle. So if I turn it on, you can see that zone 1 turned on and is watering. For demonstration purposes, I changed it from 20 to 1 minute in the code, so that way we don't have to sit here and watch the sprinklers for 20 minutes and waste water. I'm going to speed up the video a little, and as you can see, zone 1 now turned off and zone 2 turned on. Now I am going to speed it up again, and zone 2 turned off and zone 3 turned on. But again, it is not connected. Next, I'm going to show you around the device, starting with the valves that I have outside. So outside, I have three valves. The first two from the top are connected and the third one is not. It is there for future use. Anyway, the two are connected to three conductor gray wire that goes inside the house and connects to the sprinkler system device. So let's go take a look at it. As you can see, this is the device and it is nicely mounted to the wall. Starting from the top, we have the device itself. Next, we have all the wires coming from the box. Starting from the left to right, we have the 5-volt power wire, and that is simply connecting to a 5-volt power brick that is connected to an extension cord. But ideally it should be plugged directly into the wall. Next to that are the sprinkler valve wires. Then finally is the sprinkler valve power adapter wires, which go to a power adapter to power the sprinkler valves when the device allows it. But let's take a closer look at the control box. It is all housed in a nice plastic enclosure. Anyway, if we open it up, we can see the custom PCB and its components. First up at the top left is the mode switch, and we use this to either put the device into program mode or in run mode. Underneath to the left is the communication port, and this is how we are going to program the device. Then under that is the 5-volt to 3.3-volt regulator. To the right of the regulator is the terminal blocks for the 5-volt power, three sprinkler valve outputs, and sprinkler valve power adapter. Above the terminals are the three relays to control the valves, and above are the diodes, transistors, and resistors. If we flip the board over, we will see the ESP8266 right in the middle. The ESP8266 is the whole brains of the device, and it is what connects to the OpenHAB server through MQTT. That's it, that's the entire device. In the next video, I will show you all the hardware we will need and how to put it together. Alright, thank you for watching, and if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below, or head over to mksmarthouse.com/forum, where you have a better chance of getting answered. Goodbye!